sup, sup, sup. Schmishkit time. About the only thing open these days is early in the morning. Fun fishing day. Research and development, as the tax guy would call it. We're on the upper reaches of the Roanoke River. She's low. Pretty. There's more people here than I thought there would be for a holiday weekend. Memorial Day weekend. Supposed to rain. Feels pretty good outside. Upper 70s. Be pushing 85, 90 when we get done. We can dodge the rain. Wind's blowing pretty stiff, southwest. Never been up here before. Not this far up anyway. Let's go catch some fish. That was definitely wrong. I have definitely been much further than this. That boat ramp just must not be able to see it very good from the water. I have definitely been to that boat ramp many, past it many, many times. I have caught a 5-pounder off of that boat right there before. Certainly have. Test drive one of these red shad beavers. Red shad donkey punch. Oh, get that back in here. Blackfish, absolute studs. I think there's blackfish right there. Keeper number one. I'm catching by the freaking truckload up here. Settle. This fish weighs 2 pounds. Mm. 240 something. Number one. Look at that snake right there. You don't come up here and play on the trees. I won't do that again today.
Next time it'll be three times bigger. I think. Ooh. Oh yeah. 15 inches almost. Hung up in there good. Buried today. Two something, low twos, a little bit less than the first one. .214. I just bought this reel. I don't know what kind of line this guy had on it, but I left it on there since I wasn't in a tournament. I don't really care if I break it, be quite honest. I'm damn if I know what kind it is, but it's tough. It is thin. First drop back in there. God, I don't think he's gonna make it. He hooked in a bad place. Yeah, it's a short fish there. Last one. I don't weigh quite as much. My trolling motor's screaming. Old red shad power worm. You see what I'm catching? That is for sure a limit filler. I'll change up in a little while. I'm gonna go to that deadly sangria. 2 pounds even. Well, 202. I think all the way to tail. I was saying, I'll change up in a little bit. I started to get a modify a mold for something like that power worm, but why? That thing works just most scrumptious like it is. But if you need to catch some fish, catch some with the power worm. But you might catch a big one, but you're gonna have to step up to the 10 inch. But I'll be honest, I don't like that 10 inch power worm. Can't get the hook through them. So things like that are what born, or where, well, things like that was where the, what brought on the plastic company. Started playing with baits, changing them up, wanting to change the thickness, taking regular molds, changing the consistency of the worms. And now I can make them do exactly what I want to do, and it helps. But there are certain worms on the shelf that do things straight out of bag to catch fish. And this, my friend, is 1-0. So if you just want to go catch a bunch of 2 to 3 pounders, and you might catch a three, you'll catch some 3-pluses on it every now and then, but generally you're gonna have to have a bigger profile. And that's where the stud curl worm was born. That 10 inch, you can't get the hook through them real good. I don't like putting them great big hooks on them, and then you get them pecker heads biting your tail off. So, stud curl worm was born. Perfect mid-size, catches absolute giants, and you won't lose the small fish. Bites. You're not gonna get dinked eating it, but you're gonna catch way more fish with that one worm than you will either one of these. And your live well will be full. That is why we throw it. So you'll see me change up here shortly. But when I'm running new water, all I'm looking for is a bite. So that is why we got this little worm on here. And I'll be honest with you, I can feel the pressure change. And I can see the mud lines in the ditches. And I know it rained up here. It's not the most optimal conditions for catching them. So you got to downsize when that happens. So I'm looking to see. Damn, let it go. What I could catch up here, and I can already tell you it'll be 11, 12 pounds pretty easy. Because I'm not fishing hard. This is no different than anywhere from Plymouth up. Right now, I'd argue you're better off in Plymouth. The difference up here is you're not splitting fish with people. I ain't seen but a couple boats where we took off, and I bet you we don't see a boat all day. So if we can get on them, we'll have it all to ourselves. Unless there's a couple of other guys that like to burn gas like I do. But this is how you win money. You're noticing. Oh, you little. That's all we got. He's in there. Grabbing my tail. That's why you don't throw this little worm in tournaments. That stud curl worm, if he grabs it, he's coming out of there. Grab hold of that thing one time, Chief. Is that? Mm-hmm. God, it came off. Broke my line. Off of there. football. Found 60. This is definitely muddy in them hole. A lot more than I would expect, because it ain't rained up here. It must have rained up here. Get your tail out of there. He's hunting on something. That's a good one there. Very good. Freaking blackfish. And a good one too. He was up there in that mud. Whew. Molly wanted it. God almighty knows. Betsy Ross. Come out of there. Oh, that one's grown there. Boy, that current make a mean. Betsy Ross, some sun guns are all beating it down. All right, here's the cast. Got another. Well, it is decided it wants to rain. I have run all the way back down to the boat ramp. Checking a couple more holes before I call it a day. Caught plenty of fish. Didn't find what I was looking for, but found some stuff. I didn't get all of it on film, but I think y'all saw the beat down on the rocks. Measured some distances, got some times down. Found a couple of good log jams. I need this rain right here to bring these ditches up so the ditches will be worth a crap. Ain't no water in these ditches right now. Fish ain't even in here. They're out there in that river. I'm gonna poke around this corner right here and then I'm gonna head on back. See if I can't drag one more out of there. And the old donkey punch, red shad, beaver. See what's happening. Blackfish hole in here. Some logs down there. One fish hanging out. Couple out there. You see nothing up here.